Ah, we meet once again for another episode of Let's Play Suikoden 2 Into Duckness. So, it's been a few days. I've kind of had a cold for the last few days, but I think I'm feeling better. I hope my voice sounds normal again. It seems like it sounds normal to me, anyway. If it's not, then I guess we'll find out. So last time, I was in this forest. I think I came from that direction, and I was trying to find my way to the exit. And, oh yeah, and we had the old school battle music, and we kept getting waylaid by these, very, very sexy looking bandits. Yeah. Who, nonetheless, do not pose much of a threat. Okay, well, here's a treasure chest. A silver shield, that sounds good. Silver shield. Oh my gosh, protection plus 27. Holy cow. Oh, but Freed is the only one who can use it. Still plus 25 for him, and he's been having trouble with squishiness, so that might be just what he needs. Ugh. Look, ladies. I have stuff to do as much as I'd like to. Okay, let's see. Oh god, they just don't leave me alone. The ladies are all over me. And they are barely wearing any clothes either. Jeez. Okay, come on, let's get out of here. Alright, so the way to the right is the one that goes out, so there's probably another treasure chest down here, I think? Yeah. Silverlet! I don't know what that is. Ew, defense plus 11. And anybody can use it. Oh, it's one of these things. Okay, who's got something lousy? Boots. Boots stink. Nobody likes boots. All right. Boots! Okay, now. Wow, what was that? That was a very strange sound. Holy, what? It's like it's a giant slug or something. Or a giant, what is that, a centipede? It says worm, but it doesn't look like a worm. It's got a bunch of legs and stuff. Okay, well, it's time to bust out all that magic I've been hoarding. And his is completely freaking useless, so he won't. But how about this? Bolt of Wrath. That thing always... That never fails to impress. Canopy of Pet... Nah. Revenge Earth, though. This sounds pretty good. Actually, let's see who keeps getting hit. Probably one of these three guys in the front, though, could use this Revenge Earth. That sounds... Actually, there's three of them. I could put them on all three. Okay, let's give one to Humphrey. Now... Live... As the Shredding! That's the only good magic he's got. Looks like we could probably stand, do some healing and berserkitude and whatnot. And this is nothing, it's just healing stuff, so I guess we'll just attack regular. Alright, go! Berserk time! It did not work very well. Hey, he's giving the finger. Humphrey, that's not polite. Okay, let's shred him. Shred! Shred! 301 damage. Alright, now let's do the bad lightning attack. Bad butt lightning attack. I don't know. Okay, 552, that's pretty good. Okay. Uh-oh. Did not do very much damage. Okay. Yeah, that's still useless. Okay. Thunder Runner. Doesn't look very good, but let's try it. Let's give Freed the canopy defense, too, while we're at it. Everybody can have this thing. The shredding we're out of, so we're just going to have to shotgun him. And now let's Omni-Slash! Omni-Slash! Oh. Bang, bam, 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 bam. 4-4-4. Okay. You're gonna be counterattacking like a son of a peep. Ooh. Hey, whoa. Okay, now I'm starting to see why Mimir likes Clive so much. That shotgun blast did a lot of damage. Alright, we're gonna get two counterattacks out of this, if I understand how this thing works properly. Yes. Oh, and he got knocked down. Why didn't Freed got hit? Why didn't he do that? Okay. He seems that he should have also counterattacked. Oh well. I got one more, and I'm gonna put it on Sheena, just for full measure. Okay, and Nanami can heal Freed, because Freed always needs healing. Always. Every time. You see, his attack looks like it has a maple leaf, like it's Canadian or something. When he's casting it. Okay. That's right. That does very little. Okay. All the front row is all counterattack prepped, so this should be good. I think I used up his good magic. None of this stuff really appeals to me, so let's just do a regular attack, and Omni-Slash! Omni-Slash! Oh, Nanami. Dang it. 286. And my attack, Nanami didn't get involved, and my attack only did 286, and it probably only has 640k RAM. Dang it. Counterattack it! That's right. Okay. Okay. Let's see if I have any. Oh, wait, I can do an Nanami slash. Nanami's not out of action. Go! Splat, 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 splat. Yeah, that slug was not much of a threat. I have to say. I've encountered much tougher enemies in my day than that. Well, now we're gonna fight some more ladies, I guess. Fine. Whatever. Yeah, medicine. Yay. All right. Oh, there's more of this. I'm not even through it yet. Well. Oh my gosh. It's samurais and tigers at the same time. Samurais and tigers and bears. Oh my. Well. Oh shoot. The Thunder Runners actually would have been useful here. Well, that's gone. Eh, he didn't have anything offensive. Except for his stupid face. That's offensive. Okay. Well, I'm assuming we're just about to get to a town, so let's shining light these guys. Take this, you rotten so-and-sos. Go. Okay. Oh, dear. Okay. Well, I think we got this taken care of now. Yeah. Okay. How far does this forest go? Can I get in there? Is that sneakable? No. Does not appear that way, does it? Oh, here we go. I got to the end of it. Hoorah. Marcus! I remember you. But you don't have a character pick this time. You did last time. You must have gotten a downgrade in status for this game.
Hey, who are you? Where do you think you're going?
We're on our way to the Torin Republic.
There seems we have a problem. I am Vargas, chief of the Border Patrol. I cannot allow outsiders to pass through here. And what business do you seek to enter Torin?
Chill out, Vargas. This is Edmund, the leader of the Facebook army. He just needs to see my dad.
I understand the situation, but I can't let state citizens to freely enter the Republic. Allow me to escort you to Gregminster, the capital of the Torin Republic.
Really? Well, thanks. How about it, Edmund? Yeah?
Then come along this way.
Thanks, Vargas.
Yes, well, I'm sure President LePont will want to meet you, too.
Beep! Hey, this is a little bit of deja vu here. Please, wait here. To think that we're in the Scarlet Moon Empire, I mean the Torin Republic, it makes me very nervous. I just can't believe he's keeping his own son waiting like this. I'm a little nervous. I wonder where the bathroom is. Sorry to keep you waiting. Please follow me. Oh, all right, let's go. I'll be okay. Just don't on the Emperor. I think you'll be all right as long as you don't do that. Please come in. The president is waiting. Oh, I can run around. Okay, let's talk to some guards. Now, you're going to be boring, are you? Hey, this is the... Yeah, this is the original... the original theme song, the slow version. They don't have that acoustic guitar going on this time, though. Oh, well. How about you? You're just going to say, please come in. Oh, no, President LePont is very wise. He supported our young country most grandly. That's not a word, grandly. That's almost as bad as bigly. Alright.
Well met, Facebook Army Leader Lord Edmund. As President, I welcome you to the Torin Republic. Now, what would you like to discuss?
Forging an state with you. Well, I mean, this one makes more sense grammatically. What the heck? Forging an state with you. But this is probably what I'm supposed to say.
Lord Edmund, when this land was ruled by the Sailor Moon Empire, we fought constantly with the city-state. Even after the Torin Republic was established, we battled the armies of Tinto and South Window, who invaded in an attempt to take advantage of our internal discord. Because they wanted to install Windows on our systems, and we like to run Linux. And despite all this, you seek to form a state among such long-standing enemies.
If Luca Blight succeeds in destroying the city-state, the Torin Republic will surely be his next target.
This Luca fellow certainly does seem to have an unquenchable thirst for battle.
As a citizen of South Window, I fought against you with Lord Granmar. Naturally, it's hard for me to ask for your help. but Luka Blight seeks nothing less than the destruction of all citizens of the city-state. I will do anything for the people of South Window. So please, I beg of you, please consider our request.
Grr! Lord Edmund, why do you continue to fight?
Let's put an end to the war. I like that.
You are much like him. I may be the president of the Torn Republic, but there's a young man who should be sitting at this throne. He led tens of thousands of soldiers into battle and finally brought peace to our land. I see the same glimmer in your eyes that I did in his. You two represent the hopes and desires of all those who follow you. Tessa, how many men can we deploy immediately?
Oh no! Counting the Capitol Guards and the Border Patrol, about 5,000 men, sir!
Then there's the matter of who will lead them.
General, wait, which one did I have speak in the squeaky voice last game? Was it, I think it was Aelin. I did it by the character picks, and they're not giving me them. Let's just say it was Aelin.
General Valeria has come to Gregminster to report from Piano Yakuta Castle.
Kasumi, the Vice Chancellor of Kokaku, is also in town for military training exercises, the Tranning exercises. Yeah, they spelled it T-R-A-N-I-N-G. Aether would make a trustworthy leader for our army.
Yeah, let's call them in here.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's Valeria reporting as ordered. I wonder what happens if you skip some of these. Oh, Kasumi is now identifiably female. You called for me, President Lepont. Yeah, I wonder what happens if you don't recruit some of these characters, because, like, I'm sure some of these were optional. Some of them weren't, but...
Lord Edmund, allow me to introduce Valeria, one of our Republic's six generals. Her skill with a sword is unrivaled.
I am Valeria. Greetings, Lord Edmund. Is she the one who had that punch-the-crap-out-of-things attack? I think she is, if I remember right.
This is General Kasumi, Vice Chancellor of the Hidden Ninja Town of Rokkaku.
It's nice to meet you. Please call me Kasumi.
I trust both of these women with all my heart. Lord Edmund, which would you like to accompany you?
Damn, they're both hot. So which is it going to be? Which one do you want?
I vote we kick you out, Sheena.
Valeria was better, as I remember it.
Luka Blight's presence is a serious threat to the Torn Republic. I'm counting on you, Valeria.
I understand, sir. Lord Edmund, please accept what little help I can provide to the Facebook army.
Hey!
Now, please accept this, Lord Edmund, as a symbol of the friendship between the Facebook army and the Torn Republic. This is the Blinking Mirror. Oh, ho, ho, ho. One of the treasures of the Torn Republic. It was used in our war for independence, but now I suspect that you have more need of it than we do, and straight. If you use this item, you will return instantly to your castle. I've been waiting all game to get this thing. In the absence of its rightful owner, I respectfully loan it to the Facebook army in your care.
Quote, unquote, you got Blinking Mirror. Good for you, Edmund. That should help you out. Well, good luck to you. Huh, me? I'm going to stay here. I'm out of play money, and besides, I just hate fighting. Huh? What's wrong, Dad?
Oh, hey, let go. I have a request for you, Lord Edmund. Take my idiot son with you. He's not worth much. But maybe you can make a man out of him.
Okay, there's off-color jokes we're not going into there. wait a minute.
Fool, I sent you into the world on a training mission, but you just frittered your time and money away. Learn from Lord Edmund's example in your childish behavior, and don't come back till you do.
But...
I trust him to you, Lord Edmund.
Yeah, I was kind of hoping to get rid of him. Let's go, Lord Edmund. Under the circumstances, we don't have much time.
Sheena, move!
Yeah.
Valyria Convoy joins party. Okay, so what do we do? I can't get rid of any of the ones I want to get rid of. I want Valyria. I want to try Valyria out. Okay, who's getting kicked out? Is it Humphrey, Clive, or Nonami? Humphrey's like bad tank. Clive is long range, and Nonami lets me omni slash things. I like omni slashing things. Okay, let's see. Humphrey is slow, but he's very strong. He's your basic tank, right? No magic to speak of, but just stronger than heck. Clive is actually got lower defense than Nanami does and the same attack. What the heck? Same strength. Higher tech level. Lower magic. Lower speed. Lower prot, whatever that is. Lower magic defense. Lower luck. Nanami seems to be better pretty much all around, except for not having long range. So, sorry, Clive. Well, actually, wait a minute. Wait. No. I gotta see Valyria. No. What's Valyria? Is Valyria short range or is she long range? Because if she's short range, I want to take Humphrey out because he's the only... then I'd have four short ranges and I can't have that. In fact, if I remember right, I think she is short range, so I think I'll take Humphrey out. I know, I'm sorry, Humphrey. Yeah, she's short range, so yeah. The only place for her is in the front row. Okay, let's do this. I don't get to explore the castle, I see. Thank you very much, Lord Varkas. We can handle it ourselves from here.
Please be careful. If we lose one of our six generals, it will hurt the Republic's reputation.
I see what you mean. Well then, let us hurry, Lord Edmund. Okay. Oops. Oh, I can go back. Huh, interesting. I wonder if those pigeons that run away are still there. Run away, pigeons! Oh, they're... Oh, yeah, they're there. Run, run! Run, you little pigeons! Haven't been back here in a long time, and the last time I was here, it was all creepy and depressing. Have you come from the city-state? How far away that is. Welcome, this is Gregminster, capital of the Toran Republic. Toran Republic was founded 3 years ago when we defeated the Sailor Moon Empire. It was tough, but look at our city now. Da, 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 da. Bum, bum, bum. President Lepont is a magnificent person. He's protected us from the city-state ever since the Liberation War ended. Da, 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 da. Hey, there's a kitty cat! Isn't this house water? Isn't this house wonderful? We're so happy. And I'm so drunk, I can't even pronounce wonderful. I have to say wonderful. I think we're just wonderful. Made a lot of money on the black market during the war. Now I can afford living in a grand house like this. Da-dee-dee. I think I preferred our quiet house in Psyka. We lived in this place called the Bates Motel. It was very quiet. Nothing bad ever happened there. Da 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 dee dee. Da 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 da. I like this arrangement of the Gregmaster theme. It's upbeat. Hello, welcome. Are you a guest of my master's? Oh, I recognize you, Lorelei. Good afternoon. Oh, you. You're the boy who came to see President LePont, Edmund, right? That's me. Come with you. You mean join your army? I'm afraid I can't. I have no intention of joining a losing battle. Anyway, I'm searching for the Sindar. Never mind, it has nothing to do with you. I guess I gotta come back here when I get more peoples. This is the house of Flower General Lord Milik. He's not in Gregmaster right now, but he's such a dreamy person. If you say so. In the first game, after you defeated those generals, you had the option to either recruit them or chop off their heads. And I did recruit all of them. I wonder what happens if you chop off their heads. I assume that Millage is not in that castle. Hey, do you want to buy some tomato seeds? They're just 700 potch. I need money to buy wine, you see. Hey, and I can't make wine from tomatoes. That'd be gross. Okay. I don't know what that's for, but I guess I'll find out sooner or later. Wait, is this that house I was just in? No, it's not. Ho ho. Ho ho ho, green giant. I'm glad that these bottles didn't break along the way. This house has been abandoned since the Liberation War, so we got it pretty cheap. We're not done fixing it up, though. Slightly dilapidated crate. Hey there, we just moved here, so let's be friends, okay? Whoa, what's this? Drawers, decorated with white roses. White roses. These guys are from the House of York. This is the wine storage for Gordon's Mercantile. If I take my eyes off this wine for even a second, someone will steal it. Oh, what an important job. You took your eyes off it for a moment. Your back was turned. I just took a shot of whiskey and you weren't looking. Welcome! We have wares, tons of unique, exotic wares from as far north as Harmonia, and the Nameless Land, and as far south as Kanakon. Well, what about that? It's red pepper and ancient texts. Okay, so you buy ingredients. Celadon urns. Flower painting. Okay, wait, this is left by the Sindar people. The Lorelei was looking for Sindar stuff. I wonder if... I'll go talk to her again, see, remember, figure out what exactly... Antiques are very expensive here in Gregmaster. I'm gonna make a bundle. If you ask me, I'd go for wine. Cheap and delicious. It's very popular. We sometimes have sales on old books here. So if you're in the neighborhood again, please stop by. I didn't save before I came in here, and now I'm going to get chewed out. Guess I should have saved, and there might have been old books. How about some native costumes? They're cheap and very well made. And also kind of racist, probably. All right, let's see what we got here. No old books. Rats! I thought that old book would have been good, too. Well, let's go see. Let's see. Let me finish this bottom row here. Hey, there's some civil war in the city-state of Jostin. They must have it hard. Yeah, you could say that. Do 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 do
dun, dun. Welcome to Murray's Inn. Even Lord Bigdole has spent quite the night here. We're quite a historical hotel. Would Bigdole also hit out here from the bad guys? I wonder if that room I hit out in is still up there. It might be.
Hostess here just likes to talk. I'll probably do the same thing tomorrow, too. Who are you? There are humans, kobolds, elves, and dwarves here in the Torn Republic, almost like our own Two River! What's up? See something strange? You're Edmund, right? I hear you're here to see President Lapin, huh? Oh, I heard from one of Marie's hostesses. So another child leads an army into battle. It's ironic, isn't it? Why would that be ironic? Here, take this. Used to belong to a fool. Got a cyclone. Nobody can beat me when it comes to washing clothes. Oh, God, it's you. But making beds? I have to get one of the hostesses to do this from now on. He's got one track mind, that one does. This is the hideout room. Oh, miso bean paste. Should have brought Victor here. He could have skipped out on the bill.
Earth, are there kobolds in the city state too? Really? Really? Wow, I didn't know that. I'm gonna have to tell the chief.
Good afternoon. Food's delicious here, and you can't beat the ambiance.
Came here all the way here to see the hero from the Liberation War, but they say he's away on a journey. Too bad.
Huh? You want to eat?
Yes, these two here are the sea where we get all our fresh fish.
Well, they're only able to live so peacefully because of Lord Bigdole, the hero who saved us when he was just a boy. This beautiful city, Gregslist, was built by the last Emperor Barbarossa.
Ah, pigeons! Pigeons!
Haha, actually they look like seagulls more than pigeons, but whatever. Okay, alright, what was your deal? Searching for the Sindar. Well, it's worth a try. This might be a complete blind red herring, but... Okay, I'm gonna take an ancient text from the Sindar. But you never know, it might be like a clue to their existence or something. And just have one, thank you. Alright, here, take this text. I guess not. Okay, I just burdened my inventory with a useless item. Hooray! Okay, well, let's see what's in here. Tiny little house.
Mina, Mina, where are you? Mama's right here, but...
ABCs of cat rearing. Cat rearing is the cat's. Okay. We're full of water. Oh, that darn lot. She says Mina's lost again. Sigh. Now I've got to find her.
Yeah, and on such a nice sunny day like this, so I just want to sit in the sun and take a nap.
Might never know when Lady Sonia might be back, so we always keep her house spick and span. Bookcase. Come on, old book, old book, old book. Nah. There's nobody that doesn't know the name Lord McDole, leader of the Liberation Army. Except for us, because we don't say it right. His name's Bill. 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 Bill Maher, the science guy. This is the Hunt of Sonya Shulin. The Admiral of the Imperial Navy. Liberation Army. Eh. Filing stew. Sideboard. Sonya's diary. Returning here from Scheherazade was agonizing. Of course, I realized that memories weren't put on this earth just to comfort us, but... Yeah, we just... Nobody seems to mind that I just go read someone's diary without permission. All of her, like, her servants and stuff are just like, eh, whatever. Go ahead and read the diary. Sure. This contains her most intimate private thoughts. Haha, birds. Okay. Isn't this where Bill's house was? I think this is still Bill's house. There's just no door anymore. Is that why Bill's not the president? They took the door away off his house and he couldn't get out anymore? So he's like eternally stuck in his house? And it looks like the windows have bars on them too. Yeah, what a sad state of affairs. He and I stock up on this wine and take it to the City Republic. City Republic? What the hell is that? General Teo's son has grown up to be a fine, fine young man. They're all full of water. Okay, what's going on here? Welcome, how about Titan Crystal? Mother Earth. Highest order of the Earth. But I don't care. Let's see what I got here. Cyclone, highest order of the wind. Ooh, highest order of the wind. Well, hey. Poison. Put it on your weapon. Poison somebody's weapon. Interesting, although you can't seem to do it.
Yeah.
Well, let's see. Life has wind, and this one's better than wind, so why don't we just get rid of the wind rune? It seems it has obsoleted itself. Then we can go ahead and put the cyclone in its place. Quack. Okay, oh yeah, what's going on here? Windmasters are so tough to deal with, don't you think? No. Maybe I should get that Mother Earth thing. Does somebody have an Earth rune? Let's see. Yeah, Sheena does. I don't like Sheena, though. I don't think I'm going to keep Sheena, so you know what? Eh. No. Armor, don't forget that we're the oldest shop in Tehran. We have good lines of protector, whatever that means. Oh, I think you meant protection, like defensive armor. But you said lines of protected, lines of, oh, whatever. So there's a war over in the city-state. We had one, you know, two, 3 years ago. Big one. Hooray. I find wing boots here sometimes. I just love them. Well... It seems that a lot of stuff that's supposed to be here isn't today. Can I get up into the castle grounds? Oh, I can. Look at this. What the heck? There was like a castle grounds in front of this with like the dragon stables and stuff. I guess I went straight into the castle. Lord Grinseal, co-commander of the Republic Guard, is just so cool, so handsome. Guy named Conan was just arrested for fraud right here in the capital city. President Lapont would like you to have this. Please take it. Copper hammer. What's that for? Up to blacksmith level 12? What? Cool. I wonder. I probably have to have a blacksmith in my, castle first. I wonder if there's one to recruit somewhere around here. All this belongs to the Republican Army. Sigh. I can never get them shiny enough for Kai, our martial arts instructor. So this seems to be the part of the game that just, like, name-drops everybody from the first game. I don't suppose I can steal something. Rows and rows of spears. They won't mind if I take one. No, yeah, maybe they probably would. Alright, let's get out of here. This room is devoted to the hero of the Liberation War, Lord Bugdol. After the war was won, Lord Bugdol departed for parts unknown. But actually, he just got trapped in his house. It's very sad. No one realizes it. Worth of the Tor- Oh, I got an old book! Nice! Hero's Close, replica. Okay. They don't mind I just steal a book out of their castle. Why not? They're not gonna miss it. President LePont's wife, Eileen, is a very kind person. She's even kind to me. I'm grateful. Yeah, this... Oh, that's right. Of course the layout of the castle is going to be different. The original one burned, like, blew up for some stupid reason. I keep forgetting about that. Lord Edmund, please be sure to see our fair city as well! Scarlet Moon Empire. He's Lord Aelin, co-commander of the Republic Guard. Just so dreamy, especially the way I voice him. I've come as a messenger for Lord Kazim Hazil, who is protecting our northern border. Gorgeous flower arrangement. Total Torn Republic Census List. That's boring. Small case. Lord Edmund, please make yourself comfortable. The room is beyond is the center of all Gregminster. Okay. I think I already saw that one. Yeah, I can't go in there. Okay, fine. Well, it looks like I've seen all there is to see over here. So... might have to come back to get some special shop items. Eh, who knows. Excuse me. I'm getting kind of... Hey, I'm locked in. What the heck? What? I'm locked in here. I have to talk to some guy to let me out, I think. I think he was up here. Yeah, it's this guy. Yeah. I don't know what he's doing on the total opposite end of town from the door, though. Okay. Back we go. The thing I realized about these scantily clad ladies that attack us. I mean, the first thing you might notice about how, like, poorly equipped they are, or poorly dressed for, like, forest combat, is the fact that they're barely wearing any clothes. But it looks like they're wearing high heel shoes. Like, they're like, trudging through the freaking forest wearing high heel shoes and doing battle in them. No wonder they, like, go down and, like, with hardly any effort. Jeez. You know? I mean, what is that? And then those loincloths they're wearing, like, wave in the breeze, and it looks like if they waved a little too much that, you know, might be compromised a bit. Oh, tigers. Let's go kick the butt. Let's go kick the butt. Let's go. Kick the butt. Let's go. Okay. Okay. Yeah, alright. I wonder if I can use the blinking mirror in here. I don't think I can. I think I have to be in the world map. Where's that thing? Where is it? Where's my blinking mirror? Uh-oh. What? Where's my blinking mirror? Oh, it's special. I see. Okay. It must have been so you can't accidentally sell it or dispose of it like you probably could have done in the first game if you were really stupid. But yeah, it only quacks if I try to use it in here. I gotta get to the world map first. Which means I ever want to go to back to Gregmister, I'm going to have to go through this whole thing, which is kind of ridiculous. But you know what you're going to do? It's just that, I guess. Okay, well, at least I'm not getting random battled very often. Of course, by saying that, I'm probably going to jinx it. Although, you know, so far so good. Apparently the scantily clad ladies are finally leaving me alone. Wow. Freaking samurais. You know, at least they're, like, properly dressed for combat. I mean, I don't know what's going on with those damn ladies. I mean, it just seems horribly impractical. Oh, freaking tigers. Yeah, I know. Now you're gonna be burning bright. Hope you like that. Okay. Okay, now the incredibly slow ladders. With my luck, too, the plot's probably gonna have me come back to Gregmister about 5 times. I have to go through all this every single time. Boy, that's gonna be a hoot. It's going to be a gas. A veritable. Ugh. Oh, there's 5 of them. Oh, yeah, I should have stayed at the inn. I wonder if I got any of my rune back. Oh, this falcon rune. I can use this as much as I want, can't I? But I can't. It doesn't cheat with the range like the old one did. Well, that's just fine. Hey, I got the Thunder Runner back. Okay, go. Alright. Please let this do as much damage as I'm hoping it will. No, it's kind of a waste, isn't it? You know what? Valeria is not just any better than those ladies that were attacking me on the... Well, I guess they got to attract the teenage boy demographic somehow. Yeah, look at that. When she attacks, it almost looks like you could see something if you were quick enough. Jeez. All right, well. All right. Okay. Oh. Nah, I'm gonna slash someone just for the heck of it. Take this, you fiends! Take that, and 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 that! Yeah, look at that. That's ridiculous. Yes. Tell she's a fearsome warrior, because a fearsome warrior has no regard for appropriate body covering during battle, because there's no way that could go wrong. Oh. Okay. Alright. Which way? I don't remember. Is it this way, I hope? Oh, look it. It's the Valeria clones. Well. Oh, That one over there looks kind of like Luca from... Wait, Valeria didn't get to move. I'm just gonna let... I'm gonna let Valeria finish this round. Get him! Get her. Okay. They must be from whatever tribe Valeria's from. That must be the explanation for their sartorial habits. Freaking tigers. Yeah, this one's bark is worse than his bite. Okay. Which way goes out of here? Please tell me it's this one. Oh, this is ridiculous! Ugh. Get me out of here. Oh. No. This move's pretty great, though. She's like a one-person omni-slash. And the animation's quicker, too. Actually, let's see how that does compare to omni-slash. It was 114. And... Omni-slash does... this much. I do love the face that these tigers make. Okay, it's nowhere near as good as Omni-Slash. Well, whatever. Valeria is still good. I like her. Okay. Okay, back to Banner Village. Okay, here we are.
We're here to meet you, Lord Edmund.
Valeria, is that really you? It's been a long time. I don't know how much help I'll be. I'll do all I can. That was a run-on sentence. I hope I can help, too.
Lord Edmund, the Highland Army is approaching. Luke of Light must be back. Let's hurry to Everest Castle.
We don't have a second to spare. And we get auto-warped back to the castle. We'll be in the Great Hall. I'm sure you're exhausted, Lord Edmund, but please go to the Great Hall first.
Really?
Well, no one tells me what to do. So, what I'm going to do instead... Hey, where's Bulgan?
Where's Bulgan? He's gone.
Where'd he go? It looks like everyone's got new dialogue. I'll check that out next episode, but... First, let's check out some stuff. Apparently there's a hidden door I missed over here somewhere. Where did he say it was, or she, or whoever it was that said this? Let's see. Oh, yeah, it's the... Oh, no. I didn't save, and it's been a long time. I'm not doing it.
Hey, Bashik, what are you doing here? It's been so long.
Ah, hi-yo.
What's wrong? You seem depressed.
Hi-yo, I want to have a cook-off with you.
By shock, why do you?
Hi-yo, I challenge you to a cook-off. I want the recipe you stole, the Moonbird recipe.
That's the silliest sounding recipe I've ever heard of.
But why? You and I are friends, Edmund. What should I do?
Hold on a minute, because I'm not doing this right now. Okay, so apparently... Oh, there we go. That's actually a door. Oh, and look. Guess what? Someone's just sitting here doing the wash. It's funny, but I love to do laundry. It makes me good to make something dirty clean again. Great. You have such a complex and deep character. Oh, Mr. Edmund, want to play with me for a while?
No! No! What?
What in the heck is this? Whatever it is, I don't want it. Okay.
Hey, look, look, isn't it beautiful, Bonaparte? Take a good look, you see Bonaparte?
I don't actually see Bonaparte, where is he? Ah, whatever. Okay, well, I guess also there was something near the door around here. Oh, this thing. This box. Suggestion box. No letter inside. You guys told me there was supposed to be something here. You lied to me. You lied. Most foul. Lies. Deception. Okay, I'm gonna put some stuff away. Okay, what's stuff I don't need? Obsolete runes, boots. I should sell some of this stuff. This is kind of crappy. The copper hammer is probably not good until I have a blacksmith in the castle. Yeah, that was kind of a bust, wasn't it? Oh yeah, there was some like seeds that I don't know what to do with yet. Yeah, we're gonna read an old book. We're gonna read an old book. Oh yeah, we can also see what this has to say about Gregminster. The map. What does the map say about Gregminster? Let's see, it's probably like down here in the south. Let's see. Oh, it's actually not on my, it's like south of this map. It's not on the map. Well then. Wait, I already read that. The Gate Rune War. The war in which the Torin Republic defeated the Scarlet Moon Empire is known as the Gate Rune War or the Liberation War. The first leader of the victorious Liberation Army was a woman named Odessa Silverberg, a.k.a. Joan of Arc. She was originally Imperial nobility, but her lover was killed by the Empire, and so she joined the Resistance and formed the Liberation Army. The original members were Fleek, Humphrey, and Sanchez, but according to another member, Victor, the later victories were due to the intervention of Bigdol, son of the 6th Imperial General. During the war, Odessa was killed, and Bigdol took over leadership of the Liberation Army. Bigdol followed the advice of General Matthew and set up Gora Castle as the new Liberation Army base. I thought it was called... Shoot, I forget what the name of that stupid castle was, but I'm pretty sure it wasn't Gora. Okay. Can't remember the stupid name of that thing, but... After many battles, they succeeded in overthrowing Emperor Barbarossa. However, after helping form a new nation, Bigdol journeyed off to somewhere without ever seeing the fruits of his long labor. Well, that's... great. Looks like I'm missing old book number 2 and 6. I wonder what the heck happened with those. Yeah... Microwave dinner is ready. The tournament crystal's shining. Yeah, let's save. Okay, and... what the heck? I'm gonna take on that cooking challenge. It won't take very long. Let's go and take on that cooking challenge. Now that I've saved up. Oops. No. All right, let's do it. Okay. Yeah. Let's do this. And here comes the guy with the bugle on his lanyard.
Hello, everybody, and welcome. Now let's get started with today's cook-off. I'll be your host today. My name is Futon Chen.
Clap, clap, clap.
First, I'd like to introduce today's panel of judges. This spicy food lover likes to make his own kimchi at home. It's Tsavai of the Divine Spear. I think Tsai and I would get along pretty well. But that's not how you spell kimchi. So he likes spicy stuff. Yay. This pampered poodle from the Torn Republic is hard to please. It's Sheena. Well, that's helpful. That's just helpful as heck. Ah, it's Sheena. Dang freaking Sheena. Yuck. This wandering metmaker, Templeton. We can expect a fair score from him. Hans is our mild-mannered armor. How are you feeling today, Hans? Pretty good. How about a salmon mouillère? Whatever that is. The four judges will be evaluating today's dishes. Alright, let's introduce our challenger. Today's challenger is... Chef Bashuk. And now, the person we've all been waiting for. Blah, blah, blah. The person that the contest is hugely rigged in favor of. The judgment will be based on three dishes. Now take your place and get ready to cook. Okay. Okay, so the only clue I got is spiciness. So we're gonna frickin' make things spicy. Now, let's see here. What would be good to make spicy? I don't know what tamagoyaki is. I think someone told me and I forgot. Well, let's see. Teriyaki? That's kind of a main course, though. Alright. I don't know. I've been able to get through this thing by through pure dumb luck so far. I don't know. Let's make a spicy tomato soup. That'd be pretty good. Red hot tomatoes. That sounds like my sort of thing. Alright, how the main course? Oh, you know what? No, I take this back. Let's do a spicy gyoza. The Hass Szechuan gyoza. Now that'd be good. Yeah. Okay, now what am I going to make for a spicy main course? I don't know. Let me put a little spice on a teriyaki. I think it'll be all right. Barbecue bomb! Ho, ho, ho! And for the dessert, let's make cake. Let's make it like one of those chili chocolate cakes. Fire cake. Yeah, let's do this. I don't know if you've ever had a cake with chocolate and like chili powder in it, but boy, that's good. All right, let's get ready to mash buttons, I guess. Ready, mashing buttons, mash buttons, mash, 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 mash. Oh. Oh, how's that guy teleporting all over the room like that? He's not just a bugle player, he's also a teleporting bugle player. Crazy. He's nuts. He's teleporting all over the place. And he's like blowing his horn right in Edmund's ear. That's so annoying. Boy, and then he's blowing it in the challenger's ear and blowing it in everybody's ear and just generally being a pain. What a jerk. Okay. Button mash is finished. Let's see how I did. First, let's see what our judges thought of the challenger's appetizer. Fish fry. Okay, show us your scores. They hated it! Haha! This is a good start. Now let's see how they liked my champion's appetizer. The Szechuan gyoza. Man, you'd better like that. That'd be fantastic. Oh! Yay! Except for dumb Sheena. But what am I going to do about him? Tch. Okay, what do we got this time? We got a
Fried rice. Yay. That's the most boring thing in the world. But they loved it. Okay. Great. Yeah, this is gonna be way better. Barbecue bomb! Yay! And Sheena's a stupid little son of a blankety blank, but... Alright. How did they like the dessert? It's a sweet omelet. Okay. Have my chili chocolate cake. Fire cake. What? He only gave it a 3? You dork. Oh well. I think I kept him happy most of the time. I think I won this one. Yay! I creamed him. I cleaned his clock. The winner of today's cook-off is today's champion, Chef Hayo! Oh, that was out of tune. Well, I'm afraid it's time to say goodbye for now. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time. Buh-bye. I love the way they, like, face palm when they lose. Reminds me of world-class track meet. Or if you're lucky enough to have it, stadium events. I knew it. I'm no match.
Why, Bashak? Why are you acting as an agent for the group?
I'm sorry, Ayo. My daughter, Mei, she's terribly, terribly ill. I need money for the doctors. It's way more money than I could ever earn in my life. That's why I had to. The Black Dragon Group said they'd give me the money if I brought the moon bird recipe.
Bashak!
Ha! What a fool you are! You believe that old sob story?
Hey, you're the woman from before.
Yukuron. I don't know how to pronounce that. You.
Alright.
Don't be angry, Hayo. After all, you were once one of the four lords of the Black Dragon group, too.
I remember.
Don't talk to me like you're my friend. Whatever happens to your daughter, it's got nothing to do with me.
You swine.
See you again, Hayo. Today was just a greeting, but the next thing you know, mine.
This is way more drama than I expect in a cooking show.
Bashok! I'm sorry, Hayo. I was a fool. Even to save my daughter, I should never have done such a thing.
I forgive you, my friend, but what about your daughter?
Don't worry, Hayo. I'll figure something out. Mei wouldn't be happy if I used dirty money to help her. Anyway, it's not your problem. Please just watch yourself. That guy is serious.
I'm not afraid. I got lots of powerful friends here.
Yeah, I can see that. Anyway, please check this, Hayo. I hope it'll help you.
You got fried rice recipe. Well, goodbye, Hayo.
Journeyman Crystal is shining. Do you wish to save? I sure do. I think I can save over that last one since we won the thing. Alright, so that's it for today. Hope you all enjoyed it. Remember to hit like on the video and remember to subscribe if you want to see more of that. See you guys next time. Later.